In the last video, we had learned about how to control four different devices with just one Sonoff Basic. If you have not seen that video, you can watch it here. In that video, we had also discussed about attaching a temperature and humidity sensor to our Sonoff Basic to get the real-time data and use it to trigger certain automations. So in today's video, we will learn how to wire, configure and use a temperature and humidity sensor. So let's get started. To install a temperature and humidity sensor, we need a free GPIO pin. As we had used all available pins in the last video, we will free up one GPIO pin by removing this button and will add the new sensor to it. This is a DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. It cost $1 only. The bare sensor has 4 pins, while its module comes with 3 pins only. The first and the last pins are for VCC and ground, which is the name of our channel 2. And the second pin is the data pin that we need to connect to a GPIO pin on the Sonoff. So very simple, let's connect it. So we have made all the connections. To configure it, let's move on to the computer screen. So this is a Tesmota main page for our Sonoff switch. Now to configure our sensor, click Configuration and Configure Module. Here we will replace the button with a DHT11 sensor. Hit save and it will restart the switch. After restart, you can now see 3 new entries for DHT11 sensor on this page. Here we are getting the temperature, humidity and dew point readings in the real time. Initially, these sensors may display incorrect values as they are not much calibrated. Hence, we need to calibrate them first. To calibrate, you need to have the correct values from a calibrated sensor. Once you know those values, we can correct our sensor's value by adding or subtracting the required numbers to match the actual readings. For that, click Console and enter the desired commands in the command line. For example, if you want to increase the temperature value by 5 degrees, you can type temp offset 5 and press enter. Similarly, if you want to decrease the temperature value by 5 degrees, you can type temp offset -5 and it will change the displayed values accordingly. In the same manner, you can also change the humidity values too. For that, type hum offset and the number that you want to add or subtract from the displayed value. Click main menu to return to the main page. Here you can see the changes that we have just made. By default, these values change every 5 minutes, that is every 300 seconds. If you want to change the delay period also, you can do that too by entering the command tele period in the console. Here we have changed the refresh period to 10 seconds only. Now these values will update every 10 seconds. So here we are done with the sensor wiring, configuration and calibration process. Let's now move on to the next step. If you use Home Assistant, you can display these sensor values on the front end and can create an automation to use these values to trigger certain tasks. Let's move on to that part. Although you can add these sensors manually to Home Assistant, but there is an easy way to add them automatically. For that, we need to enable auto discovery of our Sonoff switch to Home Assistant. Go to console and type set option 19 to 1. That's it. Now all these switches and the sensors are visible to Home Assistant. Let's go to Home Assistant front end and add these switches and sensors to it. All the switches and sensors are now visible in our Home Assistant instance. Let's now create an automation using these sensors. So our new automation is saved now. Current humidity value is 59. Let's now artificially increase it above 65 by blowing into the sensor to check if it triggers our automation and turn on lamp 1. So here it is. As soon as the value crossed 65, lamp 1 has automatically turned on. So it's working perfectly fine. So friends, that was all for today. Hope you can now integrate DHT sensor with your Sonoff and automate many things as per your imaginations. I'm sure it would be a lot of fun tinkering around, and it will open up a lot new ways to automate your smart home setup. If you have any query or suggestion, do comment below. If you like the content, consider subscribing this channel. Stay connected, stay safe, and we will meet in another exciting video soon. Until then, goodbye.